Traditionally, most APIs on the internet today use a system called REST API. Here, you send a request to a specific URL, like /users, and the server sends back some data in a fixed format, maybe with all the user info, whether you need it or not. And this exactly is the problem with traditional REST APIs. While REST APIs are great, they often bring too much or too little data. For example, if you need only a user's name and email, the API might still send you the entire profile, with name, email, photo, bio, address, etc. This is called overfetching. And further, if you need data from multiple endpoints, like /users and /posts, you might have to make multiple requests, and that's called underfetching. Now, to solve this mess, we have GraphQL. But what is GraphQL? Well, GraphQL is a modern API query language developed by Facebook that lets clients ask for exactly what they need, with nothing more, nothing less. So instead of multiple endpoints like in REST, GraphQL has a single endpoint, and you can shape your request however you like. Think of it as a buffet where you choose what goes on your plate, instead of being served a preset meal. Here's the key idea. With GraphQL, you write queries, kind of like asking a question, to specify exactly what fields or data you want from the server. Here's an example. This query means, get me the user whose ID is 1, but I only want their name and email. The server then responds with this, so you get no extra data, no multiple calls. You get just what you asked for. Pretty cool, right? Next, how does GraphQL work? Well, GraphQL has three main parts. Schema, which defines what data you can ask for, like a menu. Query, which includes the request you send, like ordering from the menu. Resolver, which states the function that fetches the actual data from your database, or an API. Here's how a simple GraphQL setup might look in pseudocode. This shows the full flow. The query asks for something specific, the resolver fetches it, and the schema ensures that the structure of the data stays consistent. But even with all this, you may still ask, why even use GraphQL? To answer this, I'll state that GraphQL is popular because it's efficient, flexible, and developer-friendly. Efficient as it fetches only the data you need, nothing extra, no wasted bandwidth. Flexible, as you can get multiple resources in a single query instead of juggling many endpoints. Developer-friendly because it's strongly typed. That means the schema defines what's available, so developers always know what to expect. Evolvable, as it lets you add new fields or types without breaking existing queries. And it is front-end friendly and perfect for React, Vue, or mobile apps where developers can shape their own queries and get clean, structured data. So, think of REST like ordering from a fixed restaurant menu. You can only pick the dishes listed, and each dish comes as is. GraphQL, on the other hand, is like telling the chef exactly how you want your meal. Like, just the pasta, no sauce, and a little bit of cheese. You get exactly what you need, nothing wasted. Next, let's quickly resolve some common misconceptions. 1. GraphQL replaces REST. Nope, not really. It's an alternative approach. You can even use GraphQL alongside REST in hybrid systems. 2. GraphQL is only for big companies. False again. Even small startups use it because it reduces back-end complexity and improves front-end performance. 3. It's hard to learn. Again, nope. Once you understand how queries and schemas work, it's quite intuitive. Here's a comparison table for your reference. Lastly, I'll say that GraphQL isn't magic. It's just a smarter way to communicate between clients and servers. If you've ever been frustrated by APIs giving you too much or too little data, GraphQL is your new best friend. In short, GraphQL equals ask what you need, get exactly that. Like my content? Feel free to subscribe to my channel for more. Like and share this video with someone who may need it.